With this video, we conclude the topic of the IDA views. Let's start with the Segments window. It shows a summary listing of the segments or sections within a binary file. It has the following layout: section or segments name, start and end addresses, permission flags where R is readable, W writable, X executable, D debugger only, and L created by the loader, and a few other attributes. If you double click on a segment, it jumps to the start of the segment in the disassembly. We will briefly cover the segment registers window. It contains a list with the segment register change points. The segment registers depend on the binary file's processor architecture. For example, a file meant to run on an Intel processor will typically show segment registers DS, ES, SS, and possibly FS and GS, while an ARM binary would typically show the T segment register, indicating what portions of code contains thumb instructions. The grid is simple: start address, end address, length, value, and a tag. Tag A denotes a change point added by IDA during autoanalysis, while U is used for those specified by the user or a plugin. If you double click on a register, it will jump to the location in the disassembly. The signatures window displays the signatures IDA identified and matched against the open binary file. Signatures help IDA label functions and data items. The grid shows the file, whether the signature has been applied, the number of recognized functions, and the library name. You can also manually apply additional signatures by pressing Insert or selecting the option from the context menu. The Type Libraries window shows the predefined data types and function prototypes, taken from the header files included with the most popular compilers. You can load the type library by pressing Insert or choosing that option from the context menu. Once loaded, definitions from the type library can be used in IDA and the decompiler. You can use them in function prototypes and global variable types, and when adding new definitions in the local types window. The cross-references window contains all references to the current location. If you double-click on a reference, you'll jump to the exact location. You can also add and delete cross-references by pressing Insert or Delete, or choosing the option from the context menu. Now, we'll talk briefly about the Address Details window. This window contains three sections: Name, Flags, and Data Inspector. The Name section offers the same features as the Rename Address dialog. It lets you quickly rename locations by entering a new name in the edit box and viewing and changing various name attributes. The flags is an expanded version of the print internal flags action, but it does not provide details of instruction operands. The data inspector section shows how the bytes at the current address can be interpreted in various formats. The next window, the bookmarks, or address bookmarks, lists all the active bookmarks created in the disassembly, hex view, or pseudocode. It contains the place and the label or description of the bookmark. It is good to know that you can group two or more bookmarks in a folder. If you are in the bookmarks window, double-click on an entry, and IDA will jump to the relevant address in the disassembly, hex view, or pseudocode. If you want to add just general notes in the database, not related to a specific location, then the Notepad window is the right solution. Finally, you can access all the subviews by going to View, Open Subviews, Quick View, or Ctrl plus 1 hotkey. Select the desired window and confirm. We hope that you enjoyed this video. Show us how we did it below, and don't forget to keep following our channel for more helpful content.